Good afternoon and welcome back. Today I have come to Dulichand Motors with one of my subscriber, Mr. Shaikat, and he will be going to take delivery of new Exxon XC model. Yes, XC model. And for that we will be going for a pre-delivery inspection. As you know, pre-delivery inspection is a must when you take delivery of your new vehicle. Why pre-delivery inspection is must? Because there may be some problem with your vehicle. Sometimes what happens when the vehicle is in transit, it may suffer some damages. A dealer may give you an stock lying in the stockyard. So you must make sure that the vehicle that had been delivered to you is the model which you are looking for. Also, you should ensure the manufacturing year of the vehicle. So let's go there and find the vehicle in the stockyard, and I'll do the pre-delivery inspection as per request of my subscriber. So let's go and find out the vehicle. Finally, I have reached the stockyard of Dulichand Motors, and here I am going to do a PDI of my subscriber's Nexon XC petrol model. There the car is, and let us go and do the PDI. As you know, PDI is a must before taking delivery of a car, because there may be some issues even with a new car. Sometimes a dealer may sell you a car lying in the stockyard for a long time, or sometimes there may be an issue when the car is delivered in transit. It may suffer some damages while loading and unloading. So you have to make sure that the car is in perfect condition, and also you should tally that the engine number and the chassis number as provided by the dealer matches with the car you are taking delivery. So let's do it. First, let us take a visual inspection of the car. First, we will take a visual inspection. This is the car in question, Nexon XC model, petrol. I won't go for a review or overview of the car. I will just go through the PDI process. First of all, I will make a visual inspection of the entire body, whether there are any dents or scratches. This may happen even if the car is new. Maybe the loading and unloading process. I am making a visual inspection of the entire body. My subscriber is also looking at the car. Now let's check the other areas. You should check these door sill areas. Normally, if a car lies idle in a stock yard for a long time, these areas may prone to some rusts or some variations in color. So these areas should be carefully checked. Then your rubber sill areas, if there are any signs of, yes, this area should be checked. If there are any signs of any welding or anything like that, sometimes any accident or something like that may be covered up. So you should check these areas, whether there are any spot welding marks in this particular areas. So these are the areas you should check. Like this, you should check all the doors, your weather strips, if you can find any damage. Normally, there should not be any damages. That is the golden rule. These door sill areas. Like this, I will check all the doors. So everything is perfect so far. The door areas. Everything is fine and perfect. No signs of any damages. the boot area,
particularly these areas, if there is any rear ending collision or anything like that.
That's the spare tire.
No signs of any damages. Let us check the other side, the other areas. So everything is perfect. All the four tires, most of them should have near about the same manufacturing date.
Now let's check the chassis number of the car that has been provided by the dealer.
T627.
So that is the chassis number. Let me tally it. Ball.
MAT. 627.
Yeah.
225. 223M. 8M. LG 45673.
Okay, it's absolutely perfect. Let's start the engine and check the air conditioner. We have started the car, and we'll check the AC through. It has started to cool. The outside is quite hot now. By this time, yes, the cabin lamp is working and the AC has started to chill. That is the glove box. Close it and open it again. Yes, it's working perfectly. Now let us check all the levels of air conditioner. So it's working in all the positions. You should check that it doesn't become sticky or it's not hard to move. So the rotary dials are working perfectly. And that is the fan speed. Check all the fan speed. Please check all the fan speed. Okay, now start one by one. This is in first position, this is in second position. And this is the final position. Okay, it's cooling. But I feel the AC should be little bit chill. I don't know, it may be due to the car is lying outside. No, theek hai. That we'll check while the dealer takes to PDI. The AC effect, I should have expected little bit more. Now checking the engine. Let us tally the engine number. The engine is shaking quite a bit more. Now I am checking the engine with the engine running and with the air conditioner on. The engine is yet to reach the operating temperature, so that's why it is shaking a little more than usual. Let us tally with the engine number. Now let us
RLB, okay. TRL,
yes.
11G,
okay.
YHK,
okay.
6197,
okay. So the engine number tallies and the manufacturer is 672021. So it's a latest manufacturer. So these are the areas that should be checked if there is any damage or anything like that. Each and every strut towers are in good condition. No signs of any damage or anything like that. So everything is okay. The coolant is also okay. We check the headlights and all the indicators whether they are working or not. Yes, they are working. They are working absolutely okay. Headlights, So both the lights are working, and let me check the rear lights. Okay, the rear lights are also working. Okay. So all the indicators are working. All the indicators are working. Yes. Also, let me check the odometer reading. The odometer reading is around 37 kilometers. That is to be checked also. So dealer has covered 37 kilometers. So it's okay. Nothing wrong in it. So by now the AC has chilled sufficiently. But I expected a bit more punch if I compare with my Ultras. I expected a bit more, maybe since the car is new and it takes some time to the air conditioner gas to circulate. So already the windows have frosted. So the AC is working perfectly. So that's it for the PDI. The engine has been checked, the body has been checked, the rear tires has been checked. I have also checked the Stephanie and everything. So that brings to the end of our PDI session, and once we tell the dealer that we have successfully checked our PDI, he will go for the delivery process and he will send the car for registration. As I told you, never take a car delivery without doing a satisfactory PDI from your point. So that concludes our session of PDI. Hope friends you have liked the video, and please do subscribe my channel for more videos like this. Thank you very much and goodbye.